Good evening, class. How's everybody doing today? Hope everybody is having a wonderful Wednesday evening. It is Wednesday, right? Yeah, it is. Okay. Had to double check. How's it going, Hazmat, Icy Skizzer, Spoon? Welcome on in. So, Spoon, it is Castlevania, but which one? Can you identify which Castlevania game this is? If you can, you get the gold star. And you know you want a gold star. This is a often maligned Castlevania entry that I nevertheless have a lot of fondness for. But yes, welcome on in, everybody. Well, then I will leave the star on the table for now. If I take a break later, you might get another chance to guess. Or a different game. Who knows? This is a great soundtrack, though. Regardless of your feelings about the game, the soundtrack's unquestionably one of the NES greats. No, it's not Circle of the Moon. This is one of the NES Castlevania entries. But tonight, we're not playing NES, we're playing Doom. I saw a meme a while ago that kind of inspired this class. That was something along the lines of, you know, someone buys a high-end PC, you know, spends thousands of dollars on a top-of-the-line PC and continues to only play 30-year-old games. And I might have seen myself in that meme. I might have felt a little attacked by that. Hey, Chair, how's it going? Yeah, exactly. So then I thought, you know, okay, I have, you know, an NVIDIA RTX 3070. I have a high-end graphics card capable of, you know, ray tracing and all these amazing things. And what am I doing with it? You know, I'm playing Doom and I'm getting capture footage from an NES. So I thought, okay, it's time to step into, you know, the current year. It's time to show it off, time to do ray tracing. And I thought, well, what game can I really show off what ray tracing looks like with? And the answer is Doom. As an April Fool's Day joke. Hey, Bitefire, how's it going? As an April Fool's Day joke. I say joke, but it had a lot of work put into it. A fork of PR Boom Plus was released that enables ray tracing for just Doom 1. Other WADs aren't really supported because a lot of work had to go into, you know, identifying things as light sources and, you know, assigning lighting values to materials, etc. Yeah, exactly, Moon from Mars. You need that, you know, heft to be able to reach a stable frame rate. Yeah, it's not a bad fate, Chair. There's a lot of good stuff to play forever. So, really what I figured, though, is I need, you know, we finished off Eviternity last week, and next week I'm planning on starting Sunlust. I needed a nice, fun, low-stress kind of in-between thing, and I couldn't think of what exactly to do, so I thought, why not show off, you know, just some fun stuff. Let's just have a little fun. So let's take a look at what Doom looks like in a slightly different way. So let me get changed so that I'm in my best ripping and tearing attire. Give me just a moment. There we go. All right. And let's head on over to our Doom screen. Now, if things look a little strange, if the capture is not working as well, do let me know, just because there's a lot. I'm having to run Doom a different way than I usually do. So this will just be plain old Doom 1. But like you've never seen it before, I'm willing to bet. And let me know, you know, if the volume is good enough. So as you can see from the demo here, things look pretty dramatically different. Now this is still Doom 1. But with accurate lighting, essentially. So I'm excited to give this a try. And of course, we've got that classic sound. Now, one change that has been made to the game is we have a flashlight now. Because without that, portions of this would be pretty much unplayable. But you can already see there's reflections on all kinds of surfaces. Barrels of toxic sludge now emit light. You can see the floor tiles are lightly reflective. You know, this is the real deal. This is actual ray tracing in Doom. There was a ton of work that went into this to make it possible. So let's take a look at the original Doom as we have never seen it before. And you can see there's kind of diffuse lighting coming in from outside here. I think I need to turn up my mouse sensitivity a bit for this. Give me one sec. I don't really have my, yeah, we gotta turn that way up. There we go, that's better. So you can already see this is, the Nintendo hire this man effect has, Matt. Yes, you have. You have, Ranger. Welcome on in. The thing that's funny, though, is that these are still all the original assets. No changes have been made to any of the actual textures apart from assigning them, like, normal mapping values. You know, the textures themselves are unchanged, but all the lighting is going to be very, very different. Whether it's better, I wouldn't say it's better, but it's a fun kind of novelty, you know? Just a fun way to look at something. Or like, our muzzle flash actually, you know, illuminating the way the imp fireball moves. Makes for some, you know, pretty dramatic visuals, honestly. Exactly, Ranger. It's a fun experiment. Don't take it too seriously. Hold on, I'm about to sneeze. Let me mute myself for a sec. There we go. Sorry about that. It is just a fun... right, matches? They've taken it a bit far. I think it's a fun little, you know, experiment. Yeah, right, Mr. J? Because you look at it and it doesn't look like Doom. Even though this is, you know, unquestionably in the Doom engine, you know? Nothing's changed that much. Oh, I thought it was just that the lighting properties were changed by fire. Point being, most of what's happened here is not a, it's not a reskin, is what I want to stress. It's that things were assigned values to make them work in ray tracing, because the way Doom does lighting is essentially not lighting. I mean, the reason they did it, Matches, was mostly just, you know, as a joke, to see if they could. Yeah, it's a neat little experiment. I've tried it with other Doom WADs, and they are not supported. You know, Doom 2 worked a little bit. I got... This is Doom 2022, Elliot. It'll look pretty dramatic when we go to, like, the, maze-like parts of this level, and we can turn our flashlight on. Yeah, that's right, Eddie Munster. There's, places that are completely unplayable, essentially. Also, I don't have my PR Boom Plus settings exactly how I like them just yet. Oh, I think Doom 64 would accommodate this a lot better, but it would take a lot of work to get there. I do think it is pretty cool just seeing, like, the way that explosion just cast those shadows. I don't know. It's neat. It's fun. This is PR Boom Plus, Emperor Spoon. A fork of PR Boom Plus was released on April Fool's Day. Solely as a, joke, pretty much. You know, they just wanted to see, is this possible? Can we make ray-traced Doom 1? And the answer is yes. Yes, you can. It's quite an achievement in terms of, coding. I do like the way the floor kind of fluoresces with the goo. Very cool looking. Obviously, this is also a very casual playthrough. I'm not going for, like, all secrets, all kills. Just, you know, a leisurely playthrough. Yeah. I'm just kind of, you know, walking around. Just enjoying how this looks, mostly. Yeah. Like, when we go to map 3, I'm not going to bother with the secret exit. I do like how you can see there's very slight reflective properties here. Like, you can see that metal reflecting the stuff behind it. Very cool. Also, I've gotta say, class, I think I've discussed this before on stream. I don't want to say I'm not a fan of Doom 1. Because, you know, I've played this so much. Oh yeah, if we turn off our flashlight here, this area becomes genuinely really moody and atmospheric. Pretty cool. The ceiling lights, you know, bathing everything in red here. But the original commercial Doom games don't really hold a candle to what came later in terms of fan-made content for overall quality. I doubt it, Ranger. The Quake 2 one was very impressive, but Quake 2 being an actual full 3D game, you know, made with brushes, makes it a lot more doable. Also, this fork of PR Boom Plus does support NVIDIA DLSS. Yes, Lunacy. But, so you can, I think I've got it rendering at 720p right now, which is a reasonable, you know, load for, my computer to handle. But if your computer was having trouble running this, you could run this at a lower resolution and use NVIDIA DLSS to upscale it to, more modern resolutions. The fact that you need to use DLSS to upscale anything in Doom is deeply funny to me. Just that it's even, like, an option. Just really, really silly in a very good way, you know? Do I want to go grab the chain gun early? I can just kill them. No, this is actually a version of Doom, or rather a version of a source port for Doom that just released on April Fool's Day, for obvious reasons, that enables ray tracing. So this is the, you know, original Doom, essentially with ray tracing enabled. Which makes, I mean, this room actually looks pretty cool with all the imp projectiles going. Oh yeah, Marathon did use colored lighting sectors, didn't it? If I am remembering correctly. You can see, you know, this isn't perfect, but it's cool seeing, like, actual lights. I don't know. I'm getting a lot of fun out of the novelty value of this. There's just something very silly about a almost now 30-year-old game supporting one of the newest visual features in games. Oh, see, Lunacy, Doom's auto-aim is so ingrained in me as a player. So one thing that looks extraordinarily cool are the way they dealt with specters. So specters, for anyone not in the know, are the pinky demon that, you know, is partially invisible. So you can, you know, see through them. So in this, they've done something really cool. You see that? The Spectre is now bending the light around it in kind of like an active camo style. Yeah, the Predator effect, exactly. And it looks absolutely awesome. Super cool. Like, that actually, I would like if that was in the newer Doom games, because it looks extremely cool. Yeah, no, in fairness to myself, Mr. J, in other games, I have no trouble aiming omnidirectionally. In Doom specifically, I am useless with mouse look in Doom. It just feels wrong to me. Spectres you can drink. I think especially the Pinky's projectile looks so cool. Oh, so I've played Doom 1 in VR via... It's like nut you can play with outside. Was that like carpet you can play with outside? Hey, Russian bro, did you know you're an unbookish buck-washing knave? A rank-scented cockered maggot? Hey, Nonara, how's it going? We are playing Doom with all the graphic settings on. We are playing with ray tracing on, and I'm not joking. We are genuinely playing Doom 1 with ray tracing enabled. Which feels very, very silly, but I am enjoying it. I hope you enjoyed your insults, Russian bro. It's very cool matches. Like this hallway here. Now we've got diffuse lighting coming in from the sky. But you know, you can see quite a dark. Also, you can see kind of the technology falling apart when it's a little too dark. But it's pretty cool. And then you go outside and it's nice and bright. I don't know, there's a lot of really good novelty value here. And speaking of novelty value, what we're going to do after this is take a look at a weapons mod for Doom called High Noon Drifter that adds a bunch of Wild West madness. I don't know that it's entirely possible, Nanara. Something like killing the Cyber Demon would become very difficult very quickly, I think. Oh, look at how dramatic this is. Also, let's destroy this barrel because it will spoil the effect. So normally, hey Mechanicat, yeah, I'm doing well. Normally what happens here in regular Doom is you grab the blue key, all the lights turn off, and a monster closet opens up right here. Kind of the original monster closet. Also, there's my shadow. So let's see how it looks. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Scene lit by your muzzle flashes. I did destroy the barrel on purpose so that it wouldn't still be giving light. Also, one thing I noticed when I was playtesting this, if you're in a dark area, you turn your flashlight on, you turn your flashlight off, its light lingers just for a second as if your eyes are adjusting, which is a really cool little detail. Very well done. You know, for something that's basically a joke, this has a ton of work put into it. I would love to see if the tools are available to make, you know, basically to apply the lighting changes that were added here to other Doom mods, because there's some levels I could imagine. I also adore how that Spectre looks. Extremely cool. I would love to see if, you know, more complex levels would fall apart in this. I did manage to get level 1 of Plutonia to run this way, and it looked pretty cool. I've gotten some levels in Doom 2 to run. Yeah, no, the thing is, Emperor Spoon, officially this only supports Doom 1. So anything beyond Doom 1 just may not work at all. You know, some don't load. Yeah, there's a lot of levels I think it would probably fall apart. I mean, Plutonia, it wouldn't even load in level 2. Well, no, it wouldn't load level 2. I was able to load level 7. So maybe I'll load up Plutonia and give it a try and see what I can get working. I mean, I'll try it. Yeah, I'll load up Nuts.Wad. Why not? I'm not afraid of BPRD. So it is fun seeing, you know, these classic rooms in a new way. So that's what this is, you know, this is just a fun little novelty. Seeing really familiar locations looking totally different. Also, I never take the secret exit because the secret level in Doom 1 sucks. This looks nice, though. I like the kind of very light... E3 M9 is fine, but E1 M9 sucks. It's not good. It's probably the worst level in the episode. And I'm not particularly, you know, a fan of most of Doom 1 outside of Episode 1. You know, Episode 2 has a few cool things going for it. And most of Episode 3 I can skip. Episode 4 is fine. You know, Thy Flesh Consumed has a couple really nice maps. Mostly the first two. This is kind of neat, though. You know, seeing... This room's pitch black unless you have your flashlight on. Yeah, if you, you know, change the order in... Yeah, the opening two levels of Episode 4 are way harder than everything that comes immediately thereafter. Which always struck me as kind of strange. Yeah. I mean, E4 M2 is the best level. And somehow it only took John Romero, what, like 6 hours to make? Is his speed map. You know, it is hard to kind of bring your mind back. I sure am, Cream. I am playing Doom with ray tracing enabled. So there are real shadows on stuff. Light acts appropriately. I think I managed to get myself stuck in this room somehow. There we go. So you can see actual real ray traced lighting. You do need to have an NVIDIA card that can do ray tracing to play this. Yeah. It's not a challenge. From a gameplay stance, this is not challenging at all, but these are also maps I am, you know, played since 1993. I'm not trying to, you know, set the world afire with my Doom gameplay. Actually, someone asked me the other day if I would be interested in, like, why I don't speedrun Doom. And I've never been interested in it, which is strange because I've just spent, you know, the past month plus speedrunning Yonoid on NES. But something about Doom, my fun with it, I guess, doesn't come from, you know, going fast through the levels. It just comes from playing normally. Oh, I not only avoided the Noid, Mr. J, I won so decisively in the Noid race that All Bones Jones is having to PNG tube as the Noid all week. Also, this makes this maze a lot cooler. Actually, I had something really funny happen last night. I was just, you know, watching a stream before getting ready for bed and was wondering, like, oh, you know, maybe I'll play a video game while I, you know, watch a stream. what should I play? And I was looking at my NES games and thinking, well, I don't want to start something that's like a long adventure game. And then was looking through, you know, action games and platformers, and I ended up putting in Yo-Noid. And I started to wonder, like, am I broken that I just reach for Yo-Noid now when I want a game to play in my idle time? And not only that, shut up, Woozle. But as I was playing it, my NES started glitching out, and I got the most incredible, like, glitched out Yo-Noid visuals I've ever seen. Yeah, or if I was going to speedrun maps, Chair, I would probably run maps that are kind of made with speed more in mind. Like, there are maps I've watched other people speedrun include stuff like Zone 300 and Zone 400 by P-Corf, Paul Corfiatis. And those look like they would be a lot more fun to speedrun than just regular old Doom. Yeah, my NES is telling me to give it a rest. That's fine. I've got a much better, well, not much better. I've got a different game in there now, Astyanax, which I will be playing Friday night, which is cool as hell. You're gonna enjoy that one, class. Look at how cool the Spectre looks. Like, they should bring this idea forward into the modern Doom games. Also, I was alerted to the presence of those fireballs, not just by the sound, but by the visual, the change in the light. Revenant bus speedrun. I mean, Revenant bus isn't a speedrun game, it's a high score game. You know? Man, that will never not be satisfying. Just getting a good barrel shot. Also, the way everything just is lighting up with the muzzle flashes. So satisfying. You know, I know this isn't, you know, I think a lot of the levels actually end up looking worse because Doom didn't have real lighting, the way the developers wanted the maps to look was essentially baked into them. You know, with lines painted on, you know, shadows basically painted on the ground to denote how the game should look in terms of light and shadow. So we do actually lose out on that. But in a way, I think it, that kind of underscores how much attention to detail there was in these original levels. At least visually. Gameplay-wise, they were still figuring things out. Just chuck loads of hit scanners at you and call it a day. Which is fine. You know, at least there's no chain gunners in Doom 1. Doom 1 really does just feel like a tech demo for Doom 2 in terms of, you know, the actual gameplay that's there. Yeah, it is a bit much, Chair. It's cool. It's a fun novelty, I think. And I'll show off a few levels in the other episodes. I'm not going to play through all four episodes of Doom 1. There's no point to doing that. Though watching or playing this, I'm reminded of, you know, I've watched a bunch of other VTubers play Doom 1. And, oh, that looks pretty cool. That looks pretty nice, actually. But watching people play Doom for the first time, and for whatever reason they're playing, like, you know, DOSBox Doom 1, it's like, please, if you want the vanilla experience, play in Chocolate Doom. Something, anything. Don't just play, you know, there's no good reason to play vanilla Doom 1 anymore, in my opinion. Unless you're strictly testing if something's vanilla compatible or that's the way you prefer to play. Which is totally valid, like, there's nothing wrong with that. But just, if you're playing the game for the first time, please just play with a modern source port. You know, you'll end up playing Doom and wonder, why do people like this? This sucks, this is stupid. You know, play in Crispy Doom or Chocolate Doom, something, anything. I would say even this, but Not this. This would be a bit much. Oh wait, I wanted that one for the armor. This is fun as a novelty though, for being... Could you imagine if someone's first experience with Doom was Hideous Destructor Vaughn? Could you imagine? That would be a lot. Yeah. The Unity port, I'm not huge on. You know, I like that they're adding, you know, new, like, WADs to it. But I would much prefer... Well, also, notice that warping effect that comes, like, this little fisheye effect? That's courtesy of our, rad suit. That's cool. That's a really nice touch. Very cool, subtle detail. There's Romero with his triple secrets. Get out of here. That is a little nauseating, that fisheye effect, though. Fisheye lens effect. Oh yeah, that's kind of bad to have on when you're zooming. Glad that just wore off. Yeah, Bitefire, that's the thing. If you can get somebody to, like, guide you into setting up a source port and getting it configured the way you like, and then, you know, introducing you to the wide range of community content out there, I think you'll end up having a lot better time and understand why Doom is as popular as it is. Well, let me go through this hallway without my flashlight on just to see. That actually makes this scary. Yeah, I told you, Vaughn. Like, the maps are generally, you know, at least the first third of it is constructed in such a way that it works surprisingly well for Hideous Destructor. God, now I'm just imagining if you just set somebody up who didn't know any better with Doom and gave them Hideous Destructor and told them, no, this is just how Doom plays. Just to see their reaction. That would be... I mean, that would be an evil thing to do, but I really want to see it. Okay, this part should be cool. Lots of dramatic light and shadow here. This does look pretty sick. Yeah, they'll play Vanilla Doom, and it'll be like, this is too fast, I can't play this. Wow, this makes Spectres actually really threatening and a million times cooler. That was actually really neat. Also, this is totally free class. All you need is a copy of Doom. Ooh. I almost am afraid to see that. Bitefire, have you played this? I'm just going through nice and casually here. Also, do you notice how the barrels behind are in shade from my muzzle flash? That's a really nice touch. Oh yeah, no, this would not at all be my preferred way to play Bitefire. I just think it looks neat. Makes for a good change of pace, basically. Like, after this, I'm gonna load up, you know, some other WADs with a High Noon Drifter. And I don't typically play weapon mods at all, so that's a bit of a departure for me. But it should be fun to give it a try, you know? Yeah, exactly. It's exactly like that, Vaughn. It's kind of shocking how suited Quake 2 was somehow to having ray tracing turned on. Like, it worked surprisingly nicely. And obviously, you know, you can see limitations of the engine come up, you know, especially in things shadows, like shadows cast by direct, you know, objects like the fuzzy edges. It's not even, you know, like the cool stencil lighting in something like Doom 3. But it's still pretty neat to see. Okay, that's flashlight on. I do love the light effect around the imp fireball, however. That's just super nifty. No, I'll try to get some of Plutonia working after this to show you how that looked. Now, Plutonia is not supported by this, so it was pretty broken when I was trying it out the other night. Oh, that is a little nauseating. Oh yeah, no, Quake 2, I like it, but it was never a really well fleshed out game. You know, it was a showpiece for id Tech 2. Oh, speaking of tech demos, not a tech demo, but I really want to get my hands on that leaked build of Duke Nukem Forever 2001 and see how it plays, the Unreal Engine build. I don't think we'll ever get to see the Quake 2 engine build of Duke Nukem Forever, the one they showed off at E3 in like 1998. But DNF 2001 looks like a million times better than the game we actually got. Which, interestingly, Duke Nukem Forever as it came out, you know, a lot of people assumed it was on the Unreal Engine 3 because of when it came out in, you know, 2011 or whatever. But it was actually on a heavily modified Unreal Engine 2.5, which is the same engine that powered stuff like America's Army all the way back in 2002. Here's our light amp. Oh my god, that's cool. It's like a heat map. Oh, this is amazing. This looks awesome. So, Nanara, the story with Duke Nukem Forever's development is really long and mired. And I think they just decided, you know, none of it would ever end up seeing the light of day, more or less. Light amp goggles look awesome. Like, this is genuinely super cool. Alright, let's get out of here. There we go. Man, this is sick. There's the blue key door. This is so cool. Whoops. Yeah, no, this is nuts looking. In a good way. Light mode for your eyes. Okay, I've gotten flack for this. I use light mode Twitter. Does that make me a psychopath? I've heard people say that. And I'm like, what's wrong with light mode Twitter? It's fine. Huh. I think due to how this is programmed, now the light amp goggles turn on and off instead of my flashlight. It's now toggleable. Look, it defaulted to that, and if I was using light mode Twitch, then you could call me insane. I'll take the roasting, but I use dark mode Twitch at least. Is that better? Okay, it wore off. Man, that was cool though. Thank you, Mechanicat. Just makes me blind. Look, Hollow Warrior, the thing that's going to make me blind is years and years and years of driving and kayaking without wearing sunglasses. Especially the kayaking, because glare off the water is awful. Awful for your eyes. Oh, for turkey? Turkey, I like both light and dark meat. But if... Well, it depends what I'm doing. Like, if it's a sandwich, it's gotta be the dark meat. So much juicier, so much better. I do like that the ray tracing has lent some drama to some of these encounters. And really, I can't say enough nice things about how the specters look. That was an excellent design choice on their part. Hey, that wasn't nice. This open? Yeah. There we go. Oh, I thought it was 2.5 Ranger instead of 1. Point is, they were not using the most current version of the engine that was even available at that time. Which explains a lot about that game's crummy performance. Oh, there we go. I've thought about that spoon, and I know friends who have those. But I don't know, the main reason that I never wore sunglasses when doing stuff like kayaking or driving is just that I hated having to either clip on a pair or switch from regular glasses to prescription. Like, it's sheer laziness. And I probably have done damage to my eyes now at this point, but it's a bit of a sunk cost fallacy now, isn't it? Where it's like, well, I've been doing it for so long without, why change now? Man, this looks cool. Yeah, skiing, the times I've been skiing, I'm not an avid skier. Times I've been skiing, I do use, like, polarized goggles. Oh yeah, reflection off snow is extremely bright. Reflection off water is also very bright, but the snow would be worse. Where am I going? Here am I going. Those were words. Hey, Thoden, how's it going? We are playing Ray Traced Doom 1. Actually looks pretty sick at times. Like this, when we're mostly lit by muzzle flash and enemy projectiles. Yeah, no, the delays for Duke Nukem Forever were pretty much solely the result of feature creep. You know, every single time that, I'm forgetting his name, the head of 3D Realms, would see new features in a game that had just come out, he would want to add them to Duke Nukem Forever, regardless of whether it made sense or how far along they were, you know, in development and if they could afford the time or not. You know, so it really was just a case of terrible, terrible management. Oh, I actually died. Damn. Got caught lacking. Might just skip to the next level. Yeah, Daikatana, same thing. Delay after delay, and then by that point, they started Daikatana on the Quake 1 engine and assumed that they would be able to transition over to the Quake 2 engine quickly and easily, and that was not the case. You know, pretty much all their assets they had to redraw. So it was a real mess. So I'm getting hurt a lot. There we go. Not paying attention. Shame too, because we were right at the end of the map. This map's not particularly interesting. Oh, right. Final Fantasy XV, I did not personally play. I just don't have that much interest. Even though I like the Final Fantasy series, it didn't appeal to me. What I don't understand is how all these years later... Yeah, George Broussard, that was his name. I was blanking. I needed the George prompt. But, what was I just thinking? Something about feature creep. Oh, Final Fantasy. It amazes me that after all these years, there are still fans asking for Final Fantasy Versus 13. And in my brain, it's like, man, that was a trailer for a game like 14 years ago. You gotta let it go. You gotta let it go. It's not real. You know? And now with this new Kingdom Hearts, I see people talking about Final Fantasy Versus 13 again. I'm like, you have to let it go. It's over and done with. It's been so long. Please. I do have a flashlight, Thoden. Because parts of the game would be pretty much completely unplayable without it. We also have light amp goggles, which look super duper cool. And act as like a heat map, and we can toggle it on and off like we do our flashlight. Very, very neat. Slightly disorienting because we've still got the radiation suit on, which means we've got a bit of a fisheye. No, I'm the predator now. Especially because I've got, you know, the partial invisibility active. The combination of that and the heat vision. This is just, you know, Doom Predator version. Very cool. Yeah, Final Fantasy 13, I played some of the first one and I didn't play any of 2 or Lightning Returns. And a friend was swearing to me up and down. Yeah, Chase Cam with Blur Sphere on, exactly. But a friend was swearing to me like, no, you gotta keep giving 13 a try. It gets really good like 25 hours in. I'm like, I don't have the patience to play a game for 25 hours to wait for it to get good. You know? Your game should be good when I start playing it. I shouldn't have to wait for your game to become I shouldn't have to wait an entire day for your game to be... It doesn't get that good after 25 hours. Well, it's good to know that, you know, I didn't miss out on that much then. Because any time that, you know, it felt like I was finally going to get to do something cool in Final Fantasy 13, you'd, like, hit a button and then a cutscene would play, and you'd watch something cool happen, and it's like, man, I sure wish I got to do that cool thing that I just watched happen in this video game that I am playing. Why can't I do the cool thing? Yeah, exactly. It should have a draw 20 minutes in, not 20 hours. And this seems like, you know, video game 101, but... And the thing is, you know, RPGs don't have to have a slow start. You know, RPGs can hook you instantly while still, you know, introducing mechanics very gradually over the course of a whole campaign. One of my favorite RPGs ever is Skies of Arcadia on both the Dreamcast and GameCube. That game starts off amazingly. It doesn't teach you all of its mechanics right away because it knows that, you know, you've got a whole game to play first. But it starts with, you know, something awesome. You know, you're on a airship doing a sky pirate raid, and it's cool as hell, and it introduces, you know, the basics of the game without belaboring the point. Yeah, they all the Type Zero, all that, it's just too much. You know, give me the hook to start and continue playing your game right away. And that's not just, you know, that I like, you know, old games like shooters and stuff. So I love RPGs. I play a lot of RPGs. I don't tend to play them on stream. But... just, I can't comprehend a sentence like, the game gets really good 25 hours in. I could understand if someone told me, like, you know, to have the most fun you can possibly have in this multiplayer game, you need to put in the time to master the game's mechanics. That makes sense. You know, that's logical. You know, of course you'll have more fun in a multiplayer game if you've mastered the mechanics and have become really good at the game. Sure, no problem there. But if you're telling me this single player game that I need a full day for it to get interesting, that game's not for me. Though there are single player games where, you know, a time investment is necessary to get the most out of them. Like, for example, you know, something like a simulation game like Dwarf Fortress. Yeah, it'll take you a long time to get, you know, the most satisfaction out of it that you can, but it's also interesting right from the start. You know, I don't have to wait for it to become engaging. Maybe I'm just thinking too hard about it. I also didn't play Type-0. That was the PSP one, right? I think it was PSP, not PS Vita. Can't remember. And then they did a Type-0 HD. Just endless variations. Let's see. Oh yeah, I can see where I've not been. Man, that Spectre corpse is so cool looking. I'm never gonna stop getting like caught off guard and impressed by that. Super cool. That was a waste of most of those shells, but whatever. Let's not let ourselves get caught in this room. Yeah, all of the games in the Breath of Fire series, you know, they take a long time to introduce all of their mechanics, but they all have a start that gives you enough to get invested, you know? I haven't played Breath of Fire 2 in years. If I remember right, that game had quite a poorly done translation on both the SNES and Game Boy Advance version. So hold on. Where's our quick save button? That's fine. Yeah, no, there's no problem with a story-based gameplay experience. So why is this door not opening anymore? There we go. Now, I like story-based games. Yeah, exactly. If the base gameplay can't stand on its own for that long, then I think you just needed to have a better, you know, combat system, basically. Hey, thank you, Wordito. I am very fond of it. I wear it when I'm playing Doom. Keeps me safe. Normally, I've got a quite fetching boater hat on, but when I'm playing Doom, the Doom Guy helmet only seems appropriate. Let's get a little rampage going here. Spectres are much harder to actually see and plan around. Yeah, even the linearity, like, linearity can be fine. I'm gonna die again in the same spot, aren't I? No, I'm not. There we go. I will say, the spectres are way harder to actively see and neutralize in the ray traced version here. There we go. You know, I don't mind when a JRPG is linear. It's just, you've gotta be fun to play. Oh, that Spectre was stuck in the wall. Man, the imp fireballs look nice like this. I would love to see what, like, a much more demanding game, you know, much more demanding WAD would look like in ray tracing. Or if it would just melt my computer instantly. Oh yeah, 10 is also a fairly linear game. And again, linearity is not a bad thing in games. It's, is your game interesting enough to sustain its linearity? You know, or does your game have elements of freedom? You know, things you can choose to do, And 13, to my knowledge, pretty much doesn't. You know, it doesn't have a lot of that, you know, side quest type stuff or open exploration that people enjoy about a lot of the Final Fantasy series. And that's a shame. I like the green glow emanating from the nukage or the slime there. Yeah, Final Fantasy IV. Wonderful game. Still holds up well today as a game that's very fun and worth playing. Final Fantasy VI as well. Hey, Tower Shield, welcome on in, Raiders. Good to have you here. How's it going? If I can type, I can't. I don't know who Tower Shield is. Hey, you were on Sea of Thieves. How is that? Because I know that game has changed a ton since launch. Also, Raiders, for anybody that doesn't know, my name's Professor Bloom. I am a teacher. I do tons of music stuff. I organize a VTuber choir, and I play lots of retro games and tons of Doom mods. Tonight, I am playing the original Doom, but in a very special source port that was developed very recently. This only came out April 1st of this year, and it is a fully ray traced source port of Doom 1. So this literally requires, you know, a card that supports ray tracing. And it's quite the fun novelty, if you ask me. It's also just been a long time since I've played Doom 1, so it's kind of nice to go back to it. Got one more map after this one, and then I'm going to try loading up other WADs in it that are not supported and see how badly it breaks. Yeah, there's just not enough games where you can pretend to be a pirate, in my opinion. I think that was why I liked Assassin's Creed 4. Because it was one of the only games where you could pretend to be a pirate. And it helped that they had a, you know, soundtrack full of sea shanties. There we go. Give me the key, please. Let's move on. Exploding barrels are our friends. That was a nice little quick reflex shot on that shotgunner there. I'm not that slow. Oh, let me try doing one of the fancy things that Ticino likes doing, where you see an enemy and then 360. Oh, that was useless. Blazing Sails. Tell me about Blazing Sails, Mr. J. I would like to know. There was also a Caribbean Blood and Gold, which was a basically total conversion, or a new game based on the Mountain Blade Warband engine. That was very underwhelming, unfortunately. One of those things that had so much promise and then ended up not actually being particularly fun. I mean, I can always go back and play Sid Meier's Pirates. That is still a classic to this day, if you ask me. There we go. Pirate-themed Battle Royale. That actually sounds pretty sick. I remember seeing that box, like, in Game Stores hazmat, but I'd never played it. What was the basic concept there? I mean, I assume it's just all in the name, but was it like a third-person action-adventure type game? So that's what the name makes me think of, but you know how much or little you can trust names in the PS2 era. Oh, there they are. Oh, we got a nice little monster closet opening on up. Sea of Thieves, but you don't hunt people down. Semi-isometric action adventure. Interesting. Interesting. I might have to see if I can find myself a copy of that. That sounds like it may be up my alley. I haven't hooked up my PS2 in a couple years now at this point. I hope the disk drive is still good. That's always a concern with older disk-based systems. They're the ones that are much more likely to fail than, you know, your cartridge-based systems. Gun, sword, and magic. I like that. As a kid, one of my favorite cartoons was Pirates of Dark Waters. And I feel like whenever I talk to people about it, they are not sure what I'm talking about at all. But it was just the coolest thing. I mean, it was a cool pirate action-adventure show. It didn't get cooler than that, you know? Switch to the chain gun. We've got a lot of hit scanners coming up. Gotta be careful. I don't want to die and start the level over. That'd be no fun. I think there's some health nearby, but a little bit. Better than none. I'm trying to think, what other pirate-themed games are there, either in the classic era or modern? I feel like we just don't have that many. Though it goes in waves, you know? Like, for a while, there was a disproportionate number of, like, caveman games in the 80s and 90s. You had, like, Joe and Mac series, Chuck Rock, Adventure Island, Prehistoric Man, caveman games. You had all these different... Like, I don't know why there were so many caveman games in the 80s and 90s. I'm not complaining, they were generally all pretty fun. Well, Chuck Rock was pretty meh. Also, look at the lighting change with the torches now. It's pretty slick, that's pretty nice. Got that room lit all green-like. This is also the boss level of Doom 1, wherein the boss is really just two Hell Knights. Forgot seven, Granddad? What did I forget seven of? Oh, that was cool. Our shadow being cast from both torches. That's really cool. Alright, here's the fearsome boss encounter of Doom 1. It's a bunch of specters and two barons of hell. Affectionately called the Bruiser Brothers. Yeah, I don't know how realistic it is, but it looks sick. Honestly, the specters are the most dangerous part of this fight. Though I will be fair and say that as a kid, I did not know how to circle strafe. Yeah, it's hard at, you know, 320 by 240 playing mouse and keyboard keyboard only, you know. So that's how I used to play. I used to turn with the keyboard, strafe by holding down, like, period, shoot, hitting control. You know, WASD wasn't really a thing yet. And then you just automatically die. And that's the end of Doom 1. Once you beat the big badasses and clean out the moon base, you're supposed to win, aren't you? Aren't you? Where's your fat reward and ticket home? What the hell is this? It's not supposed to end this way. It stinks like rotten meat, but looks like the lost Deimos base. Looks like you're stuck on the shores of hell. The only way out is through. To continue the Doom experience, play The Shores of Hell and its amazing sequel, Inferno. So that was the end of the shareware episode of Doom. You would have to register your copy to then be sent, you know, episodes 2 and 3, which are The Shores of Hell. Which, The Shores of Hell, I will say, this looks awesome. Ray traced, that, like, iconic, you know, upside down red cross. This looks super cool in ray trace. Also, if you stand between this, it hurts you for some reason. It was marked as a hurt floor. In my opinion, Doom only gets worse from the episode 1 until you get to episode 4. Oh yeah, same. I didn't play most of Doom 1 until after Doom 2, because we got the Ultimate Doom after we got Doom 2. The Ultimate Doom included, you know, episodes 1, 2, 3, and 4. Also, we've got that nice looking blood there. Yeah. Look, in Sandy Peterson's defense, he did a lot of original stuff. I'm going to go to the Cyber Demon fight. We're just going to look through the levels here. So, you know, enjoy a little tour. Yeah, the Cross of Peter, exactly, Atropa. Oh, yeah. Doom's terrible secret level, Doom 2. E2M9. You just have a bunch of caco demons and a bunch of barons. That's it. That's the whole map. Looks cool in ray tracing. That's about all I can say for it. No, the lighting's nice now. Let's go fight a Cyber Demon. Now, the Cyber Demon was actually a scary foe in 1993. Because, you know, look at this. You've got, you know, Barons of Hell stapled to the wall, basically. And then you enter into a hellish domain. And you hear him stomping around amidst all the lost souls. And your only real weapon is a rocket launcher, which is not actually very effective against a Cyber Demon because they don't take splash damage. And now imagine that you're playing, you know, oops, I didn't need to pick that up. Imagine you're playing, you know, keyboard only. How much more difficult this would be than, you know, just being able to comfortably circle strafe to win. And then you've got these pillars in the way. That was an intimidating fight at the time. It's not anymore, because, you know, circumstances of Doom have changed a lot. But, you know, in 1993, this was not easy for people to conquer until they, you know, learned how to play. I will say the red light coming from the sky makes this look super cool. Yeah, exactly. Everything that came after learned how to utilize the Cyber Demon instead of just have him be, you know, a big walking missile emplacement. Yeah, right, Tower Shield? Well, because that bound the strafing to the shoulder buttons. Super Nintendo Doom is a real technical marvel, even if it's miserable to play. Right, Hollow Warrior? Like, and you should, because it's an unsettling, you know, kind of thing. That lost soul just very heroically threw himself in front of that. There we go. Yeah, the Cyber Demon's not frightening anymore. Blah, 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 blah. Let's see what Inferno looks like. Inferno is the worst episode of Doom by a lot. I like how the intestines on the floor all look wet. That's kind of nice. And we've got nice, just red light everywhere. But yeah, this episode sucks. Just uniformly not very fun. I mean, plenty of older games were both not fun to play and didn't look very good. Also got to appreciate the nice new water. Mount Erebus is fine. You know, it was original. No, let's look at the last map of, let's absolutely not play the Slough of Despair. Slough of Despair sucks. Let's look at, oh my god. Look at the walls of fire blue. Oh lord. Fire blue ray traced. Good lord. Look at that. Looks great. Oh my god, that is an assault on the eyes. Oh, did the bitrate just, like, go to absolute shit? That's funny. That's really funny. And now we've got the original ending map. We don't have nice contrast anymore. I'm gonna have to look back and see how crunchy that got. That's really funny. Yeah, I can imagine the ray tracing is probably pretty bad for the bitrate in general. Oh no, it does not look great, Hollow Warrior. I was being sarcastic. In fact, looks dreadful. Gotta love it. Introduction to the Spider Mastermind. Map also sucks. Let's look at... Thy Flesh Consumed looks much cooler because you've got that blood red orange sky and the frankly extremely evil teleporting shotgunner trap at the start, which as a kid, this always like destroyed me. Like completely. That opening, like I just could not do it. Now it's trivial, but I've played a lot of Doom since 1995 and improved vastly. Let me get my rocket launcher, please. Thank you. Yeah, no, this is much, much better looking visually. This map itself is still, you know, still the same map. And it's either love it or hate it. Pretty strong resource deprivation kind of map. Which, again, some people like, some people hate. I believe this one was made by American McGee. I would have to go back and check who was responsible for what maps. Ugh! Thank you, Thoden. There's also pretty much no health pickups in this map, if I'm remembering correctly. It's part of what makes it fearsome to play. Get out of there, Spectre. Thank you. Give me this, please. There we go. Oh, I'm dying. I don't think I'm making it out of this one. Nope. I blew myself up. Let's try some other WADs with Ray Trace Doom and see how it goes. So let me see if I can't drag and drop. Let me drop nuts.wad onto this and see if my computer doesn't melt completely. It probably will, but let's find out. Now, this isn't supposed to support anything but the original Doom, so this may be a disaster. Oh, yep. Can't even initialize it, so that doesn't work. Let's try... What else can I try? Let's try Scythe. Scythe probably won't work. But why not? Let's give it a go. It's gonna... Nope. Scythe is a no-go. What else do we have that may or may not work? Let's see about Plutonia. Because I got a little of Plutonia working before. So let's take a look at that. Anything that uses, like, fancy mapping features definitely won't work. I tried Alien Vendetta the other day, Chair. It did not work, sadly. I wish it did. All right, let's try... Let's try Plutonia. I know I got the first map of Plutonia to mostly work. It's not supported, and then I skipped around and got some others working. Okay, yep. So here's level one of Plutonia. So this is mostly working. And we will need our flashlight a lot in this. Let's see how well it works. Because there's some nasty traps in this level. I mean, it is Plutonia after all. That should be made very entertaining by way of enhanced, let's call it enhanced lighting. Deal with these guys now so I don't have to later. Leave those Mancubi alone. They're not bothering anybody. Why don't we go have a little tussle with an archvile? That never hurt anybody, right? I say as I start getting broiled by one immediately. I mean, I gotta say, this looks great. Just visually. I mean, Plutonia is a pretty ugly wad to begin with. You know, there weren't very many pretty wads in 1995 and 96. There were some, but for the most part, you know, stuff looked more or less like this. No, thank you. Yeah, if I wasn't waiting for this trap, having turned around, you would not be able to see that. It's pitch black. Likewise with this room, because there's no light sources. You know, the original Doom didn't need light sources necessarily. Any lighting was just something that you were applying as an effect. Yeah, exactly. Interconnected boxes. Oh, the Archie's projectile doesn't play very nice with with how the ray tracing works. Can't say I'm super surprised by that, but yeah, or like this room, there are four revenants that we're gonna fight, but without the flashlight, this would be completely impossible. Like not even remotely achievable. Let's see how revenant projectiles look. If they provide light, even. I'm not sure that they would, because again, this was really only made to work with Doom 1. Revenants are not in Doom 1. Okay, yeah, those are providing no light. So now I've got effectively stealth revenant projectiles to worry about. Which is, that's a nightmare I didn't know I could have. Stealth revenant projectiles, good lord. Say farewell to this archvile, who is really only there to perpetually resurrect that chain gunner. It's a very clever, very nasty trap. That's the kind of thing Plutonia is known for. If you haven't played Plutonia, by the way, highly recommend it. It is the like benchmark by which Doom difficulty is measured. So you know, when you can play through Plutonia on ultraviolence, that's when you know that you've begun the process of getting good. You know, that's when you've started. And it will teach you how to play Doom. Plutonia is an education. Like you might be afraid to be in a small room with a Mancubus like this. You don't have to be. You can just shoot him. It's not a problem. Wait, I still need to go through the red key door. But now, I don't think every map here is going to work. There's a trap for some more chain gunners. Plutonia loves chain gunners and revenants, to the point that it's almost a meme. Yeah, exactly, Hazmat. Enough bullets solve most problems. Not all, but most. The types of problems you have in Doom are not generally complicated. Just deal with these guys real quick, and then we can leave. Plutonia is not as unfriendly as its reputation suggests, however. I don't think it's that bad, but I also have been, again, playing it for a very long time. Looks kind of neat with ray tracing, though. So I think level 2 breaks it, so let's look at just some other levels in it. So this is Courtyard, the dead simple replacement in Plutonia. And I chose this because it is a wide open outdoor level. It's also very easy to die immediately. So you've got a chain gunner up there and then a courtyard full of mancubi to deal with. And then everything else. It is, however, an extremely fun level. Except for one trap that I find particularly distasteful, which is a teleporting archvile. But let's see what other levels work. Let's see. Ooh, I've got to check. So this map class is called Hunted. It is one of the most infamous maps in all of Doom. And you'll see why. That was a whole bunch of archviles that just teleported into this map. It does, Mr. J. So this map basically drops you into a big hedge maze with a ton of archviles, and it's up to you to get out alive, basically. Oh, there were two. The impact this map had on players can't really be overstated. Because it's just a big maze full of line deaths that trip a door opening or closing, dead ends, you know, all that kind of nightmare stuff. And then you've got kind of the demented carnival music going on, and then it'll just drop an Archie or two on you. And it's up to you to survive. It is a... I don't know if I'm going to say beloved classic of a map, but it's definitely... Yeah, it teaches you to not be afraid, to get up in their zone and deliver a bunch of, you know, hot lead right to their face. That's how you deal with an archvile. It's not a particularly good map. You know, it's pretty ugly. It's got, you know, basically the one gimmick. But that was enough, you know? Because it was a very original concept. It was a new thing, you know? And the terror of suddenly coming face to face with an archvile never really wears off, you know, no matter how much Doom you play. Just the archvile sound effect is enough to inspire dread, even in seasoned players. Now, I still experience it when I see an Archie. You know, why wouldn't you? They're terrible. They're so scary. They're these weirdly, aggressively naked dudes just running around who can end your shit in a second. Thankfully, 4 super shotgun blasts puts them in their place right quick, but still. Now, the ray tracing does almost nothing at all to this map, because it is in direct sunlight pretty much the entire time. Also, some more Archies were just released, I think. I'm surprised I haven't died with that bad hit I took right at the start. Probably just jinxed myself. And that would be fine. Oh, that's not... That opens a door somewhere. But where? That's the thing, you also just hear doors opening and closing constantly in this map, and it's disarming, it's disorienting. That's enough of that, though. Let's see... No, I'm just gonna go map by map and see which ones break the game. This looks pretty cool with the blood red. Certainly makes Plutonia look a lot different. Wouldn't say better, just different. Pretty cool though, I've gotta say. Alright, that looks pretty sick. Well, let me try it with some other wads, and then I'll move to a little bit of High Noon Drifter. Let's see, what else can I try this with? Let me try it with something that I'm almost positive won't work, but I would like to see if it does. Let's try it with Augur Zenith, which is Doomerboard's Project 37, the amazing cyberpunk Doom. There's no way this is going to work. Maybe? Nope. it's completely broken. It is extraordinarily broken. This is non-functional. Let me get into a room. How fucked is the bitrate right now? How bad does this look on your end, class? My weapon hasn't even spawned in. Okay, I tried to skip to the next map and it crashed. Let me see if Ancient Aliens can run. I doubt it. But boy, it would be cool. Yeah, not as bad as Mount Erebus. Oh, I believe that completely. I believe that 100% share. Let's see, Ancient Aliens might load. Also, I need to configure what sound font I've got for No, that's fine. We'll deal with the suboptimal sound. Nope, okay, it crashed immediately when I tried to load the map. It worked for a second, and then did not. Let's see, what else could I try? This definitely won't work, but let's see if Eveternity can load. You know, because we just played that. So let's see, can Eveternity run with ray tracing? Nope. immediate crash. Pretty much anything fancy is not going to work. So that weird wireframe was in Valiant. Or no, there was also that crazy Dragonfly map I showed off, but that I think is only compatible with GC Doom to begin with. Let's try Scythe 2. Scythe 2 is probably not going to work. Oh wait, Scythe 2 has actually loaded. Incredibly. It has loaded and it actually looks kind of sick. We need our flashlight for anything. Oh, the lava looks sick. Okay, Scythe 2 might be working. At least the first map. Incredibly hard to see where I'm going because of how dark it is, though. Scythe 2 is also one of my favorite megawads. Yeah, the 3D bridge kind of gets a little messed up with the ray tracing, but not as badly as I thought it would. I'm curious now, though, will other levels be able to work? Because I can't imagine they will. But I'm going to have to try. Also, just lighting things up with a muzzle flash is incredibly dramatic. And looks so cool. But man, this makes it a totally different experience. Like, completely different feeling. Probably about to die. This is sick, though. Take out Mr. Cacodemon. Cacodemon's projectile also leaves such a cool looking light effect. This must be absolute murder on the bitrate, though. Like, I can see nice, subtle, you know, blue twilight seeping in. But it's probably almost, like, the worst splotchy, dark mess imaginable. Oh, Berserk gives me a cool effect now. Very different looking. I'm seeing, like... Oh, there's a Spectre. Boy, Spectres are a lot more dangerous like this. Yeah, I'm seeing, like, this crazy, rage-filled vision. This is neat. This is really neat. And man, it's remarkably harder to effectively use Berserk when you can't see your own fist because it's too dark. That shouldn't surprise me, but it kind of does. The Revenant projectile not lighting up is really, makes this really hard to dodge. Good lord. Alright, will it break at map 2? It did not. Let's see how far we can push this. Hold on. Let's skip around. All of Scythe 2 might work. Oh, know what map I would love to see if I could get Alien Vendetta to load in? I would love to see how Misery Halek from Alien Vendetta looks. That would be stunning, I bet. I mean, this looks pretty sick. Scythe 2's second episode is Egyptian themed. And this is looking pretty sweet, if I'm being honest. Like, this is nice. Right? Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get any of the maps in Alien Vendetta to load when I was testing it out before stream. But this looks pretty great. Hey Xavier, how's it going? Hope you're doing well tonight. I am playing Doom with ray tracing. On April 1st, for April Fool's Day, a version of the Doom source port PR Boom Plus was released that supports ray tracing. So I'm just testing out what maps work, what doesn't, and having a good time with it. I hope you are doing well. Babysitting. Don't sit on the baby too hard. There's my dad joke for the night. I hope you all enjoyed it, class. All right, let's see what others work. I'm sure I have made more than one tonight, but hold on. I gotta see if, like, the big beefy levels at the end work. Hello. Hey, thanks for following Learnum the Necro. Okay. I tried to load map 27 of Scythe 2, which is gigantic, and it crashed. Let's try again. I want to load map 30. Map 30 is like 2,000 plus enemies and an insane odyssey. Nope, crashed. It started playing the MIDI, but it didn't go further than that. Let's see, what else can I try before I move on? All right. Since this is what I'll be starting next week, let's torture myself a little early, and let's see if Sunlust can load. Okay, Sunlust crashed immediately. Kind of relieved. that would have been too much for me. Sunlust has a lot of really pretty maps, but they are pretty and deadly. Let's try. I would describe the visuals in this set as workmanlike. This is PCORF's Zone 400. All right, Zone 400's working. The map is called Zone 400 because I think there's no more than 400 line depths in any of these maps. So they're all about kind of economy. But they work well. Also, look at that nice water. Look at that nice water. So this one seems to be working pretty well so far. If only by virtue of being very, very simple. Yeah, the hexagons are too strong. I do think I should see if Back to Saturn X can work, because that is vanilla compatible. So let's just see if some of the later levels in this still work. They do. And they look pretty cool. All right, so there's a lot I can play around with here still. Fancier things that rely on modern source ports to run might be out. But stuff that's, you know, vanilla compatible should be good to go. This looks pretty sick. Like, look at that reflection along the ceiling. Like the polished marble. That is really, really cool. It is not. So this is a specific, chocolate like vanilla. Xavier, I didn't realize you were making a joke at first, because there is a source port of Doom called Chocolate Doom. And I was about to reply to you in all earnesty that the ray tracing is only supported on PR Boom Plus. Yeah, no, so that there really is Chocolate Doom, which is meant to be like Vanilla Doom, but works with some, you know, more modern features. Let's try Back to Saturn X, which I can't imagine this will work, but I need to know. Let's see. Nope, didn't work at all. All right, why don't we switch to some more conventional Doom? What I'm going to do now is load up a very early Doom custom mod called Fistful of Doom. It was a Western themed Doom level that came out in, I think, 1994 or 1995. Very early days of custom mapping. So I'm just going to load up Fistful of Doom as it was. Look at that. That's beautiful. Also, that's way, way louder than PR Boom. That should be more reasonable. So this here is Western-themed Doom. Fistful of Doom. Now, a lot of these sprites that were introduced back in, you know, 1994, 1995, you on the right. Shoot out here in the OK Corral. Most of these sprites still are used in the Doom community for Western-themed Doom endeavors. You've just got tons of custom sounds all playing over each other at once. And, you know, for an early 90s map, honestly, I don't think the visuals are that bad. You know, you've got a new pistol. Oh, I know what I'm going to sing, Mr. J. Hold on. Give me a sec. Oh, see, I was just going to sing Big Iron. Yeah. No, we're all on the same page there. But I don't think I'm clever enough to change lyrics on the fly. Yeah, I mean, we have to think it. That's the only thing to think. Only thing to think. I think I said that backwards. So let me know if the balance is all right. I think that's a little quiet. To the town of Aguafria rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. For the stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. He came early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side and looking all around. He's an outlaw loose and running, came the whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24, and the notches on his pistol numbered 1 and 19 more. 1 and 19 more. Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around. Was an Arizona ranger, wouldn't be too long in town. He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas Red. After Texas Red. The story wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. I fucked that up. But the outlaw didn't worry, men that tried before were dead. 20 men had tried to take him, 20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. The morning passed so quickly when it time for them to meet. It was 11:20 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death. About to meet his death. There was 40 feet between them when they stopped to make their play. And the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today. Texas Red had not cleared leather for a bullet fairly whipped. And the ranger's aim was deadly with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was over in a moment, and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Big iron. Tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. There we go. Thank you, Mr. J. I would love a tropa like a Colt, you know, army revolver. That would be nice. Just as a thing to have. So thank you for the Pachis. Actually, the music doesn't add much here. Also, I've got to point out now that I can put my Doomin' hat back on. While this isn't, you know, a remarkably fun level. Well, that's good to know. Well, an old flintlock would be super cool to have. But while from a gameplay perspective, this is not a particularly good map, aesthetically, I think this is remarkable for, 1994 or 95, very early days. You've got custom textures, you've got, a nice fake glass effect here. You've got a... Hey, thank you for following, Flassic. You've got one of the first cases of using dummy enemies that are basically placed within the walls. I think they're imps that have had their alert sounds changed. And the, the flavor is what carries it. It's not particularly great to play, but you hear how the music changes in certain places, like you get, near the saloon and you hear the saloon music. That's actually like the idle sound of the imp has been changed, and I think they're embedded in the floor. As enemies that you can't fight, but they're there effectively just to act as a jukebox, more or less. So while, from a gameplay perspective, the map's kind of boring. But from a historical perspective, super cool. Not actually an easy map, if only because of all, it's all hit scanners basically, and there's lots of wide open, sight lines that you have to contend with. Yeah, like that. We're gonna cheat. We're just gonna come back. We're just looking. What I'm gonna do next, though, is I am going to load up this map with a weapon mod enabled called High Noon Drifter, which adds all new weapons, tons of features, and is just overall some really sterling work. And we'll get a true cowboy experience. So let me close this out, and then let me load it back up with that mod enabled. Let's see. This is why I like using Doom Launcher, because it lets me do these things easily. And now we've got even a different title screen. I'm sad that I never played around with it until very recently. Though I had to enable a bunch of buttons that I hadn't before. So one, you've got a reload, but you've also got a whip. That's super useful. And we can absolutely fan the hammer. Looks super cool. The whip is also really, really useful as a melee weapon. Also, I've got to turn the sounds down a bit. That's really loud now. That's a little better. Yeah, please do, Atropa. Though I will say, when I was playing around with this, I'm so not used to having to reload in Doom. It really throws me off. Modern speed loaders on a single action. Super satisfying. The guns in this are not at all realistic. I don't think they're really meant to be, but boy, they're fun. I could, but it feels appropriate to have it on, Mr. J, just for that extra bit of flavor. I will say, the action on the guns is all very satisfying. Also, instead of a boomerang, or instead of a chainsaw, you have a boomerang now, which is amazing. It's so much fun to use. Look at that. Like, absolutely spectacular. And it can bring items back to you. It's so much fun. This is whatever I think the most recent is Emperor Spoon. God, that's fun though. There's a whole bunch of features here. Also, Western Doom. That's some vintage credits for you. This was, I think, 1994. Actually, if you want to see a neat little mapping trick they did to make something appear to have a ceiling, or to be of a limited height instead of an infinite height, this outhouse over here, if you look at it from the right, you know, the proper perspective, he's shooting at me, I don't appreciate that. But you can see the outhouse just has a texture applied to the top portion of it that makes it look like the sky, so that when you view it from the correct perspective, it looks like it's, you know, all one piece, basically. Super clever. Man, this boomerang's way too much fun. Like, way too much fun. Yeah, it was a really good way to get around the limitations of the engine back then. Also, right mouse click is now bound to your whip, and that can also destroy projectiles. Granted, there are no projectiles in this one, it's all hit scan. Ooh, we've also now got the super shotgun, which can be loaded by default with 2 bullets, but it can fit up to 4, not bullets, sorry, Atropa, shells. It can fit 4 shells and unleash an absolutely massive blast that never, ever gets old. Let me show you that. Good lord. Oh, that was satisfying. Yeah, I don't think they're even gonna bother trying to explain it away. This is where the rule of cool comes in. Where if it's cool, do it. Don't worry about anything else. I also love all these little paintings throughout. Yo, this is one, don't think too hard. Just enjoy it. Yeah. Yeah. So let me see. They clearly, you know... Yeah, he's just putting 2 shells per barrel. That seems unsafe. Now, I've used double barrel shotguns. They're quite fun. You know, my brother has a breech loading over under 20 gauge that we go, you know, we'll go shoot clays with it, or God, that's satisfying. That's so satisfying. And he'll use it for bird hunting. But something tells me if I put 2 shells in 1 barrel, that's a good way to never go shooting again. Man, this rules. Oh, that's funny. Usually when we'd go to the range, be like, okay, one person's paying for, you know, range passes, one person's paying for clays, and one pays for ammo. And that's how we'd do it. I haven't done that in years now. Come here. Oh yeah, Kazi P, this is extremely satisfying. Cheesy sound effects and all. Also, I can't forget how extremely satisfying the whip is to use in this. Yeah, Outlaws. Fantastic game, Mechanicat. I saw it. Civi actually just did a video on it, so I hope more people play it. This revolver is super fun. Actually, the first time my brother and I went shooting with our father, he was saying, you know, oh, you know, I haven't been shooting since I was a teenager, I'm gonna do terrible, all this and that. And then I think he got like 23 out of 25 of the clay pigeons we launched, like, he did excellently, and we're like, are you hiding something from us? Like, have you been an incredible shot this whole time and never told us? And he chalked it up to beginner's luck. I have never gotten a perfect 25. I would love to, but where's my red key? Oh, also, this mod will make fun of you if you use cheat codes. Which I find very endearing. Well, that was close. Like, if you turn on God mode, it'll be like, play the level the right way. It makes fun of you. Oh, we've got some kind of submachine gun. Oh, I'm jealous of that Mechanicat. So the version that's available on GOG is quite good. Oh, that's funny, Mr. J. I'm also loving that sound replacement that's just now the original imp. Did I just miss the red key somewhere? Yes, I did. It was just in that room. So, you know, not a particularly engaging map as a map, but as an artifact, you know, as a little piece of Doom history. Absolutely wonderful. And it keeps going. Let's play around a little more. I do need to get used to having to reload. The whip remains shockingly useful. Boy, this is satisfying, though. You know, the map itself, nothing really special. But boy, it's fun. Let's just go on a whip rampage. Which, because I haven't fired a weapon, they actually didn't wake up. That was fun. Dual wielding, let's go. Forget about Halo, we were dual wielding a long time ago. I think that's a little loud though. Let's turn it down just a tiny bit. Oh. Forgot to reload. I like that ammo seems to never be a problem here. Game understands. Give me ammo. Let me have my fun. And man, is it ever fun. Absolutely tearing through every room. Enemies offering no resistance whatsoever. I don't know what the story of High Noon Drifter is supposed to be. I think there is supposed to be a story of some kind, but I couldn't tell you what it is. Let's see. What does the game call them? Oh, we've got ghosts. Yeah, I think there's also some weird magic element going on in this mod. I have not looked up a lot about, you know, what is supposed to be happening here. But man, if this isn't fun. You're a time-traveling cowboy, man. I'll go with that. Oh, and those are Pinky's and Spectre's, respectively. That makes sense now. Now I get it. Let's absolutely blast one into the next time zone. Oh man, that's satisfying. It's incredibly dumb that you can shoot four shells at once. But holy crap, it's fun. This is too good. I think those are replacements for the Pinky Inspector. Oh wait, I can just whip them. Forgot about my boomerang as well. Trusty old boomerang. God, that's cool. Oh, and it can get them on the way back too. Yeah, that barrel would go boom the wrong way. God, there's nothing left of him. This is fun. This is a lot of fun. I'm probably missing an obvious key somewhere, though. Oh. Sorry, I gotta stretch for a bit. There we go. That's a little better. Oh, wait, this was the... Yep, been there. I need a red key for there. This get me to a key? No keys yet. No, that's just where I was. One thing I think I would like to try this weapon mod with is Ancient Aliens, because the first third of that game really takes place kind of in the desert. The Mojave. I think it's supposed to be the Mojave. So I could live out the space cowboy fantasy. Or Augur Zenith, I think would be fun with this. What am I missing? Missing the keys somewhere. Absolutely it would fit. How do I get in there? Is there a Fallout Doom mod? I'm sure there must be. Whoop! Oh no. I've got grenades now. Which grenades are the replacement for the rocket launcher. Because that makes sense. Now... Oh, you can throw multiple at once. That's cool. Fallout? What's that? What am I missing? If I'm missing something obvious, class, please tell me. Please backseat me. I'm just missing a key somewhere. It must just be... I need a blue key for that. See, the red key's in there, but don't see... I need the blue key to get the red key. That door doesn't open. Nowhere else to go in that building. Pass the whiskey. I could use some right now. Good to see you, Holy Spokes. We are playing Fistful of Doom, which is a classic from 94 and 95. Very early, you know, community-themed WoD. But I've loaded up the High Noon Drifter weapons mod with it. Just been making it very, very fun. Only now I'm quite lost in this level. So I can't find where to grab a key. I know I need the red key to get in here, I think. Out of the door is broke. Don't think there's a way in the back. Yeah, I need the yellow key to get in there. Unless there's just a key on the ground somewhere and I just didn't see it, which seems entirely possible. I've been in this building. I've been in... Can I go in this building? I do not think so. Unless I can, like, hop across from one window to another. No, I don't think I can. I am tempted to just bail on this. Oh, there's an enemy that sees me somewhere. Means I'm probably dead the next time he catches a glimpse of me. Where was he? Come here, I've got two barrels loaded with too many shells. I would like to unload them. Unless I missed something in the mission building here. Maybe I did. Oh, something hit me. I'm gonna use that as an excuse to load up a song and pull up Ancient Aliens, which is a much more modern set. I don't know if I have your map, Emperor Spoon. Let me pull up a song, though. Not sure what to pull up. Hold on. Let me get this loaded up. No, I'm going to sing you a song, Atropa. I gotta think what to sing, because I'm not a huge country guy, so my repertoire is a little limited. Or rather, it's more limited to old stuff by, like, Emmylou Harris. Yeah, one of those nice bars where they play both kinds of music. Let me see. No, the old stuff's much better. The stuff that passes for country radio today is just bro rock with a cowboy hat and a overcompensating pickup truck. That's not my style. Let's see. Though there are some good country artists still around, they're just unfortunately not getting radio play. Don't know if you've heard of a guy named Shaky Graves. He does a lot of really good stuff. Kid Rock. Yeah, Shaky Graves is great. Like him a lot. Let's see, are there any Shaky Grave tracks on here? There's a couple, and I don't know if they're any good. Let's do something I know a little better. Oh, not as fit. Oh, that sounds like fun. This is, this counts as country, I guess, though it's really more pop by someone who sings country, but I love Dolly Parton, so. Stumble out of bed and stumble to the kitchen, pour myself a cup of ambition and yawn and stretch and trying to come to life. Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the streets, the traffic starts jumping with folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no giving. They just use your mind and you never get credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5. For service and devotion, you would think that I would deserve a fair promotion. Want to move ahead, but the boss won't seem to let me. I swear that man is out to get me. They let you dream just to watch him shatter. You're just a step on the boss man's ladder, but you've got dreams he'll never take away. Ooh. In the same boat with a lot of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in, and the tide's gonna turn and it's all gonna roll you away. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no giving. They just use your mind and you never get the credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5, yeah, they got you where they want you. Better life, and you think about it, don't you? It's a rich man's game, no matter what they call it. And you spend your life putting money in his wallet. 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taken and no giving. They just use your mind and you never get the credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5, yeah, they got you where they want you. There's a better life and you think about it, don't you? It's a rich man's game, no matter what they call it. And you spend your life putting money in his wallet. 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5. Oh dear. No thank you, Mr. Cyber Demon. For service and devotion, I swear sometimes that man is out to get me. There we go. Man, this map is cool as hell. Oh, yeah, more like 5 a.m. Dolly's great. Yeah, right, Mechanic Cat? It's just, that's Doomguy's 9 to 5. He's just out there, you know, on that demon killing grind. There we go. And now we've... And thank you for the Pachis, everybody. So we can kill this Cyber Demon. There's a nice telefrag here. Yeah. What do you mean, fortunately? I wish more maps started with the Cyber Demon. Also, the whip can reflect projectiles, which is super useful. And I need to remember it can do. Oh yeah, Dolly is a, you know, all-time great singer-songwriter. Just incredible, incredible. I mean, one, what a voice to start. Yes, Hex, we've got Ancient Aliens, but with High Noon Drifter loaded up as a weapons mod. Which, I don't play with weapons mods very often. This is just kind of like a break for me before I start the next Megawatt I play through on stream, which is going to be Sunlust. So I think I deserve a bit of fun, you know, a bit of a break before I throw myself headfirst into Sunlust, Ultraviolence, Pistol Start. You know, that's going to be an undertaking, shall we say. Also, I don't know why the volume for this seems to reset every time I tab out. That's annoying. I think that's got to be some kind of GZ Doom glitch. So let's turn the sound effects down a little bit, because that's a very loud kablam from the gun. Man, that whip is satisfying to use. Now, I think this is a Berserk. Yeah. There's like magic items and stuff that they added in here in High Noon Drifter. Oh, reflecting revenant projectiles is an actual game changer though. I think there's some kind of lore with all the stuff going on here. Yeah, it's definitely a quirk of GZ Doom chair. Also, just reminded how good Ancient Aliens is, for one. But I think this, weapon set, you know, a fantasy western, works extremely well with these levels, thematically. Or at least these ones at the start. When we get into space, I don't know how well it fits, really, but... Man, these weapons are fun to use. Really satisfying feedback on them. Great animations. The whip is extremely satisfying as a melee weapon, and genuinely quite useful. There's our chain gun replacement, which once we pick up another, we can dual wield, which, hell yeah. Dual wielding is pretty much always fun. Kill these chain gunners and grab ourselves another. Yeah, there we go. That's what we're talking about. That's so satisfying. I don't love that grenades are the replacement for the rocket launcher. Hey, thank you for following, Hex Regex. Hex Regular Expression, I'm assuming that is short for. I am no good at coding myself, but plenty of friends who are. Let's see. Okay, at least we've got some... How are you not dead? Go away. Go away. Oh, I've died. Let's try again. Computers are the devil. I'm glad that I have not made an ass out of both you and me, as the saying goes. And this whip's fun. So, I did play around with this before stream just to see, like, what are the other, you know, weapon replacements. Chain M3ers. And the plasma gun is replaced by a magic staff, which is extremely cool. It just shoots a gout of fire. Yeah, they are. Their weapons have likewise been replaced. Man, that feels so good to do. Surprisingly effective, too. Even against larger groups of hit scanners like that. It's what a good job they've done overall. Very satisfying guns. Very satisfying. Let's try not to die to an easy trap again this time. Part of this is also just remembering these levels. I mean, I played them on stream, what, 6 months ago or something, so not too long ago. You'd think I would remember them a little better than that, especially since I'm not even trying to, you know, play continuous or anything fancy. Oh, wait. I've got grenades. I forgot I had grenades. They're not grenades, they're the rocket launcher, really. I do need to remember to reload, or I'm in for a bad time. Alright, the game might make fun of me in a second if I die, because I will resurrect. We are not out for skill tonight, class. We're out for fun. But look at that trail of spent shell casings on the ground. It's a nice touch. It's a very nice touch. I also like that money act as your armor. Just seems appropriate somehow as being a traveler from the Wild West of the future, maybe. I don't know what the story's supposed to be. Well, I was not quick enough to, so we're gonna cheat. The game says, you want me to hold your hand, too? I like that. Make fun of the player when they suck at your game and cheat. I like that a lot. That's personality is what that is. Ugh. Yeah, you know, just making the game a little easier on myself. Because this is my break, you know, map set. Because Sunlust is going to be unmerciful. Sunlust is going to be deeply, deeply unmerciful. So I need to just have some fun now, you know? A nice no-stress, easy time. Man, that whip is good. Hand-holding? Way too lewd. I mean, there is a... If you want lewd Doom, Atropa, that exists. And it's something else. It's called H-Doom, and it is explicitly one of the games I can't play on Twitch. Run, hide, or die, the spiders never stop. There's actually several Doom WADs that are... like, specifically on Twitch's banned games list. Yeah, right? You already played it fast and loose tonight. Oh, the arachnotrons are getting me, that's what. Oh wait, why am I starting my counter now? Really? Oh yep, I can see that. It took me a sec. Yeah, no, Gretzo is the one I was talking about, Ranger. Explicitly on the Twitch banned games list. There we go. Yeah, that's true. There is a limit of them, it's just you can't reasonably hit it in normal gameplay. Though, Atropa, if you did somehow get banned for that, I feel like that's a pretty easy appeal on the Twitch side. I don't think they'd have any grounds to keep that in place if they reviewed, you know, a VOD. Assuming they care enough. Well, oh, I forgot to reload. The shotgun's okay. The super shotgun replacement is nuts. In that it quite literally doesn't make sense. In a very fun way. Oh yeah, I remember this fight. I love that they managed to keep that arachnotron pretty much at the center of the map at all times. It's a really nice touch. That would be very funny. Yeah, so everything got a total weapon replacement. Let me absolutely destroy myself with my own rockets. There we go. I think it does. I'm not certain. I'm going to choose to think that it does because it's cool. Seems to hurt the imp, so seems likely. Reload. Yeah. Oh yeah, it was a dreadful accent. I did like that he reprised his role in Mary Poppins Returns. You know, playing an old man, only he was actually in his 90s this time around. And he still got up on a table and danced. You know, Dick Van Dyke's like 95, and yeah, he still got it. Yeah, exactly, Ranger. I don't know if there was a bigger waste of talent in a movie than that Cowboys vs. Aliens. So you had, like, Daniel Craig, Harrison Ford. Like, a good cast, a good stupid premise. You know, stupid in a positive way premise. Yeah, right? They're aliens. It says so when they kill you. I'll do this in the style of Marty Robbins, if that's okay, Mechanicat, instead of operatically. That seems like such a shame, Atropa, that they did all that work and then the movie sucked. To the planet of Mars rode a professor one fine day. Always sang to folks around him, did have a lot to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The professor there among them had a whip on his hip. Big whip on his hip. Thank you, Mechanicat. Oh, know what movie I couldn't stand? Dr. Jones, I presume? The Will Smith Wild Wild West movie. I've always hated that movie. I always thought it was the dumbest movie in the entire world. if you like that movie, I'm not going to say you're wrong to like it, but I don't understand. And I like plenty of bad movies. That one's just... that one's too much for me. And the... everything about that movie made a lot more sense when I heard, whatever his name is, you know, Jay and Silent Bob guy. Why am I forgetting his name? When he explained the Superman movie that he had written a treatment for in the mid-90s. Kevin Smith, that's it, yes. Kevin Smith explained the whole process. You know, he went in over and over and was working with this one producer who for some reason was completely insistent that Superman at some point have to, like, fight a giant mechanical spider or giant spider of some kind, and kept saying, you know, did you know that spiders are the apex predator of the insect world or something like that. And eventually, you know, Kevin Smith was let go of the project. That was when Nick Cage was going to play Superman, which, God, I would pay any amount of money to see that. But, you know, it all fell through. Eventually, you know, he goes to see Wild Wild West, and he sees it, and that giant fucking spider shows up, that mechanical spider. And then he sees who the producer on the film was, and it was the same dude who just, he wanted his big spider, and he got his big spider in the movie he was producing. Which is just extraordinarily funny to me. Also, the guy, like, apparently wouldn't read a script. He had to have people read it to him. And he would just sit there and, like, imagine it. You know, every stereotype of, like, a Hollywood producer. Yeah, you can understand wanting to get your thing. I'm just going to skip around levels. I'm not going to play seriously. Let's just see how these all turn out. Yeah, sometimes you need a giant spider. What map, Emperor Spoon? So I don't know if I have the map. He did insist on the most memorable part of that movie. I can't deny that. Okay, sorry, I don't have my Twitch pulled up at all, Emperor Spoon, so I couldn't see it. Let me pull that up. I'll give that a play. That sounds fun. Let me download that now, actually. Give me one sec. As long as, you know, I'm assuming there's nothing, you know, stream unfriendly on it. Let me check it out with High Noon Drifter. Give me a sec. I will load that up. Sorry, yeah, I can't actually see my, like, Twitch panels. I can just see my chat, like, through OBS, so I don't see the whispered messages. Let me open that up. Add this into my Doom launcher. Yeah, if anybody else makes maps and would like to send me one, by all means, please do. Because that would be a lot of fun to check out maps that viewers make. Let's add High Noon Drifter to it. Now, should I just play through the map normally or anything I need to enable? So let's see. This map I'm about to play, class, is made by Emperor Spoon here in chat. Let me fix the sound. Did not load properly. Not sure why. Let me try loading the map normally first. Or maybe let me... what? What, IWOD does it use? Or does it need to be loaded in a certain slot? Is it for Doom 1, Doom 2, Plutonia? Yeah, that's using Doom 2. Let me unzip it instead of loading the zip. Let me try that. Give me one sec. Let me try that. See if that fixes the problem. Yeah, see, I almost always end up just loading the zip because Doom Launcher supports that. Okay, give me one sec. Then we'll be able to get it loaded properly. It's still giving me trouble. Come on. There we go. Let's make a new folder here. All right, now let's try this. All right, give me just one sec, class. There, now it's loading, and let me add High Noon Drifter to it. Okay, now we should be in business. Let's fix the sound. Let's give it a look. There we go. So this was made by Emperor Spoon here in chat. And let me give it a try. I have never seen this map before, class, so this is new to me. It is working. I do. This is looking cool so far, too. Need a yellow key for those. Whoop! Chain gunners. Let's get out of their way. Ram Ranch Doom guy. Is that the Taco Bell ding sound? Just noticing all the sounds. Windows sound for the Caco Demon hurt. Oh, this is hysterical. I can't get over the Taco Bell, like, bong sound. That's too funny. 18 naked Doom guys in the showers at Mars Colony. Hold on, I'm gonna make a save. Man, it's so dumb to be able to load up four shells at once. What? Is that what the dog doing for the pinkies? This is just one big shit post. Hey, Certified Dummy, welcome on in. I am playing a map made by a viewer right now that is full of a lot of really, really funny joke sound effect type things. Welcome on in. What were you up to? Let me shout you out.
Hello.
Hey, Dragon Slayer 21. Thank you for following. For anybody who doesn't know, my name is Professor Bloom. I am a teacher. I do lots of music streams. I organize a VTuber choir. And tonight, well, I also play tons and tons of retro games. Tonight, I am messing around with some Doom weapon mods, which is not normally what I do. Watching YouTube videos. Excellent. What about? That is how I waste most of my time, is either watching YouTube videos or aimlessly scrolling around on Google Earth. Did you learn anything new or interesting in your time on YouTube tonight? Also, I am at 1 HP, which is all the HP you really need at the end of the day. Let's hit him with four shells at once. God, that's so satisfying. It's so stupid, but it's so satisfying. Oh my god, you can one shot revenants using both the teleporter being like ear rape among us. Really, I don't know why that makes me laugh, but boy, it's making me smile. What did I just hit a switch for? Oh, I'm sorry you didn't feel well to stream normally. June's Kitchen is the one with the dog, right? It's like doing the cooking stuff. So I'm missing something obvious, I feel. Yes, I am. There we go. Now I can go through the yellow key door. Yeah, with the cats. Oh god, that just vaporizes them instantly. Oh, this is funny. Yeah, what was the build time? So I like how it looks a lot visually, and the layout's nice. These sound effects are too much. And what tools did you use? So I'm trying to teach myself more about Doom mapping off stream. Well, I'm dead. I am absolutely toast. Oh, I'm not dead, somehow. Well, now I'm dead. GZ Doom Builder. Alright, I've got some rockets now. What pass for rockets? Get out of the Archie's way. Whoop, that didn't work. Oh, I'm gonna be in a world of hurt in a sec. Nope, that didn't work. The combination of the kind of unfamiliar weapons and whatnot from High Noon Drifter with the sound effects. This is absolutely disorienting me so much. Oh god. Okay, let's hit the Archie with like the big shot. Oh damn it. What are they, the same sound replacements? Okay, let's get all kitted out here. Okay. Yeah, I don't know how you would make it conditional, but I also don't know that much about weapon replacements. Oh, that was just me grenading myself. Let's try. Gotta remember, I can throw multiple grenades at once if I want to. I just need to remember that that's an option. All right. Trying to get out of the Archvile's way is hard here. Oh, and then the specters really get me. What the dog doing indeed. Make a save. No, don't apologize. I'm having fun with it. This is a, difficult map hidden in a, small enemy count. It's easy to look and see 82 enemies and think, oh, the map won't be so hard. I should have been tracking how many times I was dying during the map, but I haven't been, I apologize. What if I just take out the Archie first thing? Or if I try to take out the Archie first thing? Might be smart.
Down.
Oh, but then there's a Mancubus right behind me. Alright, this is getting tricky. So I really want to take out any hit scanners first opportunity. But then if I go over there, I get immediately surrounded by specters. Maybe get rid of like one threat at a time. Try to be somewhere. Nope. I think that was closer. Let's try taking out that Mancubus first to give ourselves like a nice corner to play around in. Oh, I'm out of ammo completely for that. Somehow I wasn't killed instantly there. Really thought I would have been. No, that's no good. I'm gonna think what weapon would suit me best for a lot of this. Hard to say because there's no area for cover anywhere, essentially. No, I know the key is the Archvile, but I can't get him in fighting and I don't have a good position to fight him. I think I just noticed what the Archie's sound replacement is. It's like the Goku Ultra Instinct sound. Oh, I'm out of ammo. Oh, I managed to kill the Archie. Yeah, Chair, I really need to do my my map making reps. I would love to do like a map making stream. But I need to learn, you know, how to make a decent map before I do that. Oh, I thought I was out of his sight. Guess not. Let's try one more time. This can probably stun lock him a lot. Oh, but if I get boxed in, that's pretty much game over. Okay, we've got a little room to breathe. I'm gonna save, which might be foolish, but best run I've had so far. Alright, I think I should have it now. That probably would have helped, but it's my fault for not finding it. I keep forgetting that I can either negate or reflect projectiles entirely. But there we go. That was a nasty room. That was a nasty room, Emperor Spoon. You did a good job on that. That was not easy. What will that do? There we go. Completes a bridge sector so I can go open this door. I'm expecting fully at least one more trap of some kind before the level's out. Especially if I'm being given ammo. Yep. Knew it wouldn't be that simple. There we go. Hey, Floop! Damn right, respect your elders. Welcome on in, Raiders. How's everybody doing? For anyone who doesn't know, my name is Professor Bloom. Holy shit. All right. Welcome on in, Raiders. So, for anybody who doesn't know, my name is Professor Bloom. I'm a teacher. I do lots of singing. I organize a VTuber choir, and I play lots of retro games, all on real hardware, and I play lots of Doom. Tonight, I'm having kind of a break night on Doom, where instead of playing a high challenge megawad, I'm just playing a bunch of things for fun. That map was actually submitted by one of my viewers, Emperor Spoon. I'm going to... It's real hardware. So Emperor Spoon made this and suggested that I give it a play. And I can see why, because holy shit, that was funny. So what I've been doing tonight is, first I was experimenting around with a version of Doom that added ray tracing to the original Doom. And then I've just been messing around with a weapon replacement mod called High Noon Drifter. So I'm actually going to load up one more wad here. This is Augur Zenith, which is a cool cyberpunk Doom mod. Floop, I am going to remove all of your keycaps, shuffle them around, and put them back in the wrong order. Yes, Augur Zenith will work correctly this time because we're not trying to play it with ray tracing. But we are, however, playing it with dope Wild West weapons. So for anyone who hasn't seen, Augur Zenith is an absolutely stunning cyberpunk Doom mod set of levels. But we're, instead of being cyberpunk, we're being cowboy punk. Augur Zenith was one of the Doomer Boards project. Yeah, truly Wild West here. We have a whip. We've got a six shooter. We've got all manner of awesome shotguns. And Augur Zenith itself is stunning. Yeah, very much the world of Snatcher and Blade Runner. Only now I can, you know, fan the hammer on a revolver and hit people with a whip. Yeah, 1960s era six gun in the 2260s. I'll do that another stream, Spoon, because I'm probably only going to play for another 10-15 minutes or so. Keeping it to a shorter stream tonight, because I've got to be up a little extra early tomorrow. But we've got our ever-handy whip. Also, just the attention to detail in Augur Zenith is astonishing. It's just a gorgeous set of levels. Very, very fun to play. Full of nice memes, like a real human being, a real hero. Amazing stuff. This also has one of the best sight gags I've ever seen in a level. And we'll get there. The whole set is very worth playing, because look at this detailing. Everything about it is just absolutely gorgeous. Only now we're playing it with, like, crazy fantasy Wild West time traveler weapons. And it really fits somehow. If anything, this is like the, you know, Firefly Mal Reynolds simulator. You know? Where it's the Wild West, but it's in space. Oh, it's absolutely gorgeous chair. Yeah, it's just the Mal Reynolds simulator. And there is so much Doom cute packed into all of these maps. Insane. Like, the room we were in before, they're clearly at, like, a karaoke lounge. Just absolutely awesome stuff. Nathan Fillion would be proud. I loved that they, years ago when he did Castle, that other show, there was a Halloween episode and he came out, you know, in his brown coat. And some other character was like, "What are you supposed to be? Some kind of space cowboy?" And he just, you know, adjusts his jacket and he's like, "I like it." He's clearly very, very proud of it. Oh god, that's so satisfying. Also, The chainsaw is replaced in this with a boomerang, and it's one of the most fun weapons I've ever used in a Doom WoD. So satisfying to use. Way better than the chainsaw. I think I said chain gun earlier. I meant chainsaw. Just everything here is so immaculately detailed. So fun to play. The only thing I'm not used to, and that's down to the weapon mod I'm using, is reloading my weapon. That's new to me. Everything else, man. What an absolute delight this all is to play. We can also just whip the hell out of stuff. It feels so good. So just look at these advertisements. We've got the Microsoft bin bows. Hell yeah, Bitefire. And it works shockingly well with High Noon Drifter. Like, thematically. It just feels like it fits, you know? Hey, Legend Jin, how's it going? Hope you are well tonight. This is called Augur Zenith, Rob. It's the Doomer Boards Project 37. Came out last year and is absolutely spectacular. I am playing it right now with the High Noon Drifter weapon mod enabled, which kind of turns things into, you know, high fantasy Wild West. And it's extremely fun. Let's go get some secrets. I think I can do a little bit of clever platforming over here. Oh, that would be flawless for it. I mean, they sort of did some weapon replacements like that in the kind of default version of Augur Zenith. You know, like, they replaced the sound effect and the sprite for the pistol. Like, they did some of that. But it's just, what a spectacular everything they've done. I mean, just the level of detail is stunning. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous set of levels. And pretty much all of them maintain this level of quality or higher. There are a few that are just sincerely jaw-dropping. Hey, Burnsy, welcome on in. Yes, it did work. Welcome in, Raiders. Tonight... Oh, for those of you who don't know, my name is Professor Bloom. I'm a teacher. I do lots of singing. I organize a VTuber choir, and I play lots of Doom and retro games. Tonight, I am just having a good time going through some kind of silly mods and levels for Doom. Like, I'm playing with a weapons pack called High Noon Drifter, which turns Doom's weapon set into, like, a fantasy... just kind of fantasy cowboy affair. And it's extremely fun. How is Resident Evil Zero? Are you playing the remake, the GameCube original? And this here is Augur Zenith, which is Doom Reports Project 37, which is an incredible cyberpunk-themed set of Doom levels. And it fits surprisingly well with the Western-themed weapon set. Incredibly fun to play. Oh yeah, it went through. I'm very glad to have you here. And man, these weapons are very fun to use. Boomerang this guy. All 100 leeches. That does sound exhausting. I never did that when playing that game. Seemed like too much work for me. Man, this is a beefy feeling shotgun. Also, we're about to get to my absolute favorite sight gag. This is the moment, exiting this level, when I knew that I was in for something really special. And that's this right here. Absolutely, absolutely flawless. Just, I was beside myself with laughter the first time I saw that. just spectacular. Spectacular stuff. Yeah. Oh, playing some Yakuza. Excellent. I'm just messing around. I'm probably gonna call it a night fairly soon, but look at that. Opening the turnstile. Just awesome stuff in these levels. And extremely fun to play. Oh, and now I've got the super shotgun, which can do something very stupid and shoot 4 shells at once. That, Mr. J, that was the moment that I knew that this was going to be something special, and it really, really was. Also, look at that shotgun. Just... I mean, you can put 4 shells in it at once, which... Please do not put 2 shells per barrel into a shotgun. You will kill yourself. Or destroy your gun. Probably both. But it means you can melt a cacodemon. And it's extremely fun. Also, you have a whip in this, which makes melee combat really viable because it also deflects projectiles. Super fun stuff. My god. I want to know who decided... Also, we've got just wonderful cyberpunk theming throughout. Whole thing's just spectacularly well done. If you have $500... Oh, man. Yes, you recognize the chair. All the music choices in this were similarly excellent. All the arsenal you get in this is super satisfying to use. And I like that it leaves shell casings behind. It's a small detail, but it's a nice one. Oh, I think that opened a secret somewhere. I can't be bothered. Not secret hunting, really. But just look at the amount of detail in this map. It's really, really wonderful. And it's a challenging map as well. You know, set of maps. But not too hard. You know, it finds a really nice middle ground where a casual player can get through it easily, and someone, you know, a little more dedicated. Like, when I played it ultra-violence pistol start, because that's how I typically play Doom. Hello, Lyles!
Hello, hello, hello!
Oh, thank you for following. Unfortunately, I cannot read that. I used to be able to read a lot of that. I took a... Oh yeah, it's all stupendously good Doom Cube. You know, you've got people working at their computers here. The kitchen. I gotta show you, there's some amazing hello, stuff in the kitchen.
Hello, hello.
Thank you for following MZK Lopu. Appreciated. Check this out in the kitchen. So we've got our sink. We can turn the water on. Not just that, we've got our toaster. Let's have toast. And get some HP from the, you know, water. Just incredible, incredible Doom Cute. Just like, I live for that. It's so charming. Now let's melt a Baron of Hell. 4 barrels. Super nice touches, Xavier. God, that feels so good to do. We've got more Doom Cute here in the office. Can grab ourselves a drink. We can open up some hidden compartments here. which I don't know if they actually do anything, but yeah, please do spoon. I don't mind links posted, especially not to very funny maps that people made. So for anyone unfamiliar with the phrase I was just using, Doom Cute is whenever, you know, mappers use the Doom engine to do stuff that imitates, you know, real world environments. And generally it's considered very cutesy and is very, very well received in the Doom community. I certainly love when maps have a good amount of Doom Cute. And these have wonderful, just what look like mundane details of everyday life. And that's actually really hard to do in the Doom engine. Let's absolutely incinerate this archvile. God, that's so satisfying. Two full shots from that, and then Archie's done. High Noon Drifter, I've got to say, is a lot of fun so far. Exactly, Mr. J. Also, can we just appreciate all of this, like, subway advertisement? You cannot stop me. I will commit another cybercrime. I love the, like, PC-98 style, like, 80s anime artwork. Pyramid Schemes on clearance now. Just all of the details in this level are so good. I have not yet. I know I need to. Because it's a brand new game on the build engine. It's 100% up my alley. So look at this. Demon summoning program. Dopamine bullets. Yeah, it's very much that vein of science fiction. You know, cyberpunk. So we can appreciate some more of Mr. Gosling. Kind of Andy Warhol style. Dookie Nookie. It is Stardust Speedway. Let me crank it up. Get the music bumping. Let's just go evaporate an archvile. Let's see, where is the Archie? Oh, the Archie's dead. God, that's so satisfying. I also really like how the partial invisibility looks in the High Noon Drifter. Looks awesome. And it makes you faster, it seems. Man, what a unexpectedly good combo. Yeah, hold on. Is the super shotgun still too loud? Because it's very hard to get weapons and music balanced just right. Hopefully it's a little better now. Where you can hear the music and it's not totally overshadowed. Oh my god, that's so satisfying. Being able to melt a Hell Knight in one shot. God, that feels so good. Whoops, I forgot to reload. There we go. I'm running out of words for just how amazing that feels to do. The whip is also extremely nice to use. You know, melee in Doom doesn't always work great. This feels nice to use. Whoops. didn't make that jump. That's fine. Also, just look at, like, all the details. It's so nice. I can't say enough nice things about this class. Please play Augur Zenith. It's free. If you have Doom, it's free. Also, I know what we'll end on. After this, I'm going to show you the single... Oh, shit. I'll just do it now. I'm going to show you the single best secret I've ever seen in a Doom level. Which is on the level Electric Rave. This has the single best secret I can think of in a Doom map. And thankfully, it's right at the start of this level. We go into a nightclub. Very fun, very cool, very chic. You know, all that good stuff. Got our rocket launcher, which is just the grenades here. Absolutely. Streets of Rage music because good taste. Whoops, I'm dead. Know what? I'm gonna cheat and be overpowered and have fun, and I don't care if the game makes fun of me for it. We now have given ourselves all weapons. So we've got a sick staff that does fire. We've got crazy stuff now, class. And we're gonna have some fun. Because you need to see the best secret that this game has to offer. Also, I want to see how this BFG works. Oh, that's so sick. That's so sick. Oh, and the pinkies can catch on fire? It's rules. This is so cool. Alright, but let's get to this. Oh, you survived somehow. So the secret is over here in the bathroom. We have got a hidden arcade cabinet over here. And what would they have? They have Doom for arcade. Okay, let's play it. So we can either insert a coin or play free with ads. Well, I don't have any coins, so let's play free with ads. And we are now at the Chasm from Doom 2. And this is exactly the Chasm from Doom 2. Anybody who's played Doom 2 will recognize this. Only it gets better. Because remember, it said play free with ads. We're playing free, but we're gonna have to deal with the ads soon. But I want to melt this Hell Knight. Come here. Almost. Its weapons are so satisfying. Oh my god. So now... the entire level is now completely papered in advertisements. Play free with ads. even more are supposed to pop up. They didn't all load in for some reason. They're supposed to even be popping out of the floor. I don't know why they didn't, but... There we go. Actual pop-up ads in our game. Doug Huggum says, sharing is caring. You've won free stuff. You've won a free GR88 holotape player. Connect your cyberbrain, then press I win to download your corresponding merchandise ticket before time runs out. And then we've just got the entire level coded in advertisements. And then you can leave. But it's... if I were your boss, I'd deathmatch you in a minute. Which is what, you know, the original Doom could say when you go to exit the game. So that is the single best secret I have ever seen. Yeah, right? All those hot singles that wanted to date you, but you wouldn't click. You didn't click the link, so they could never connect with you. It's tragic. All those iPads just sitting unclaimed. But yes, that is the single best secret I have ever seen, I think, in any Doom map. It's astonishingly cool. And I think with that, let's end on a high note, class, because it doesn't get much cooler than that. Actually, you know what? I want to try one more thing. Because Nuts.Wad got mentioned earlier tonight. And I want to see how insane Nuts.Wad would be with High Noon Drifter enabled. If I can run it, we'll see. Let's see, I will probably have to... Oh, there we go. I haven't had to drop the resolution. Oh no, the problem is, I forgot, I had my default, the profile I set up for Nuts.Wad, which is 10,000 monsters just in two large rooms. I changed to PR Boom Plus for that, because it handles large groups of enemies a little better. So this is how Nuts.Wad goes. Holy shit, that's so loud. Sorry. Oh lord. Where are the sound options in a... There we go. So Nuts.Wad was made by a mapper named BPRD in the late 90s. BPRD is actually a, like, mapping genius. Yep, Nuts.Wad. So I can run it at a smooth frame rate because I've dropped the resolution quite a lot. Let me load it up in GZ Doom and see how poorly it's going to run. Because PR Boom Plus handles large groups of enemies. You know, like an overload large group of enemies a lot better. And let me load it with High Noon Drifter on. Just to see how much of a mess we can cause. All right. Oh, it's surprisingly okay for now. Let's see if that lasts. I don't think it will. Oh, yep. I think things are waking up, and let's watch my frame rate tank. There we go. Oh, yeah. That's not smooth at all. But man, whatever this magic thing is that I get as a BFG replacement is awesome. But I need to go get more ammo for it. D's Nuts.Wad. It's that BPRD needs to come back to Doom mapping so he can make a new sequel. Yeah, right, Chair? I think I can, if I drop my resolution, it would be a lot better. Because right now I'm running at 1440p. You know, there's no reason to run Nuts.Wad at 1440p. With all this going on. That's excessive, you know. All things considered, though, running as smoothly as could be expected, so let's open up the next room, which is nothing but Spider Masterminds. Oh, there we go. Yep, there's that frame rate. Hold on, let me drop my resolution substantially. Where's Oh yeah. Yeah, this was never really meant to be played, if that makes sense. Where is just my turn to simple options menu? That's a little easier for me to to understand. Display options. Yeah, let's drop this resolution a bit. Where even is my resolution? Scaling options. No, that's not it. Resolution scale. Let's go to a nice 640 by 400. Well, that's still pretty poor. Let's try Nope. It's a little more playable. This is why you use something like PR Boom Plus. Hey, Buffy's Buffet. This is not quite old school Doom. This is a let's go with lowest possible scale. There we go. This is a pretty much joke map that was made in the mid-90s called Nuts.Wad that was made by a mapper named BPRD pretty much solely for the purpose of testing out the idgames.com uploader. Let's go back to my normal resolution. I've gone and messed up my settings badly. That's fine. But yeah, I play tons of custom Doom 2 megawads. Let me get rid of that. Let me load up one that works a little bit better. Let's do something silly to end the night. I'm gonna load up Sunlust and add in High Noon Drifter for a sec, just cause, you know, why not? Why not? A little bit of fun. Oh, no, that crashed immediately. Never mind.
Hello,
that just didn't work. Hello, hey, and thank you for the follow, hello, Buffy's Buffet. I will be playing... Yeah, Nuts.Wad was not silly enough. Now, if you want to see what Nuts.Wad actually should look like, Nuts.Wad actually should look like this. Which is still pretty nuts, mind you. But entirely more manageable. Now, it can, in fact, run at a good frame rate. PR Boom Plus is just a much more efficient source port than GZ Doom. GZ Doom is great for advanced features, but this is, it's much too loud, for one. PR Boom Plus is much better at handling large amounts of stuff on screen at once, which is good because this map has over 10,000 enemies. And as you can see... Oh yeah, it wasn't even really meant as a stress test back then. It was meant to just test a server, and then people got kind of obsessed with it. Let me show you a more modern map. Russian Overkill, I think it's called. Let me see. Here we go. Here's another map that has... four times the enemies as a... Oh, no, that's not it. Where is it? That's not it. Sorry, I'm looking for a specific map. Here it is. This map has 42,690 enemies. Oh yeah, BPRD's work went on to inspire a lot of people. But this map is insane. This is by a Korean mapper who goes by the handle of Antares. And this is not a joke map. It's just insane. Yep, Bitefire knows what's up. Antaresian Reliquary, map 31. It is absolutely insane. Antares has to be one of the best mappers for visual detail and attention to detail in Doom. He's incredible. Also, I really need to... So the rest of the maps aren't that slaughtery. This one is just truly insane. I'm just gonna turn on God mode now. Why am I scared? Yes, I am, Antares. Because this map just... this is how it opens, and it only gets more insane from here. So it's not a joke map. You know, it's really meant to be playable. And it is. I have not set myself the task of learning it. But yeah, it is absolutely just the ultra bzzz experience. Which I apologize if that's a bit loud or annoying. This whole opening, I've watched people play this through, and really what you do is just get a good perimeter around the outside going, not let yourself get cut off, and just hold down the fire button and win. But it's easier said than done, more or less. I've tried it a few times, and I would need to really set myself the task of learning these maps if I wanted to be able to do that. But, like, look at the scale of the architecture in the background. Oh, yeah. No, that's why I'm in PR Boom Plus at, like, 640 by 480 resolution. Because I first tried this in GZ Doom, and my computer just cried. Though this is reminding me, I need to get PR Boom set up to my preferences before I start playing Sunlust. Just because I don't have everything dialed in quite right, like turn speed, etc. Visuals. In the sky? Sure is. The visual scale in this map is really stunning. Also, those guys all just got stuck in that elevator. Oh, come on, come on. Let me keep going. I can't fathom what it takes to make something like this. Another Antares map that I would really recommend to everybody more than this. Oh, thank you, Mechanicat. I needed that. More than this is the final map of THT Threnody, which he was responsible for. Has some of the most gorgeous architecture. It's a very fitting farewell to Ty Halterman. So just look at this. Absolute chaos. Yeah, no, Antares maps are hard. Struggle is pretty reasonable, though. And that's one I would recommend to people. Mech's Box of Skies. Ooh, let's see. Let me think of something good to sing us out on, Atropa. Then I think, actually, you know what? I'm just going to go back to my office, get changed, and sing us a song to end the night. Give me a sec. Because it is getting late, and I keep fighting the urge to yawn. Let me change into some more casual attire now that I am done ripping and tearing for the night. There we go. That's a lot better. Oh, get stuffy in there. Let me grab a song to end the night, though. Probably something a little quieter, just because it's it's late. I don't want to piss my neighbors off too badly. Let's see. What have I got? I've done two country-ish songs tonight. I may as well do a third. Why not? A rare all-country all-country outing from me. Oh, my pleasure, Bite Fire. I wish my voice was as deep as Josh Turner's, but I'll do my best. Maybe lock the door and turn the lights down low. Put some music on that's soft and slow. Baby, we ain't got no place to go. I hope you understand. I've been thinking about this all day long. Never felt a feeling quite this strong. I can't believe how much it turns me on just to be your man. There's no hurry. Don't you worry, we can take our time. Come a little closer, let's go over what I had in mind. Baby, lock the door and turn the lights down low. Put some music on that's soft and slow. Baby, we ain't got no place to go. I hope you understand. I've been thinking about this all day long. Never felt a feeling quite this strong. I can't believe how much it turns me on just to be your man. Hey, thank you for the cheer, Bernsey. I like country songs that are just straightforward, honest songs about how you feel. Ain't nobody ever loved nobody way that I love you. We're alone now, you don't know how long I've wanted to. Lock the door and turn the lights down low. Put some music on that's soft and slow. Baby, we ain't got no place to go. I hope you understand. I've been thinking about this all day long. Never feeling that was quite this strong. I can't believe how much it turns me on just to be your man. I can't believe how much it turns me on just to be your man. Oh God, I can only imagine. That, oh God. I don't envy you that, Atropa. But let us see who is online right now that we can go raid. Because it's been a good time. Let us raid and tear. Use whatever emotes you would like. But let's see who's online. Yeah, no, my pleasure, Mechanicat. Thank you for coming. It was my absolute pleasure. We'll go with something like this, and let's see. Vaughn's playing TF2. We could go see Vaughn. Let me see who else is on. You think I would look this up first, but no, it was a lot of fun. Let's see. Yeah. He's the lion man. he'll tell you he's not a furry, but evidence to the contrary. Let's go from one shooter to another. Oh, he's playing medic. Let's see how he does. All right, everybody, let us raid and tear over to Vaughn Leon. I will be streaming again Friday night, starting at, no one believes it. I'll be starting 6 o'clock Friday, playing Astyanax for the NES. I am going to play it either until I beat it or it beats me. And then Sunday at 3 p.m. Eastern, I will be on Nanase Kine's channel for another very cursed cooking collaboration, so look forward to that. Oh yeah, TF2 is bad these days. But thank you, everybody. Have a great night, and I will see you on Friday. Good night.